guys, JSTK. Robert decided to make some ribeye steaks, and this is actually our Valentine's Day dinner. This is gonna be part one, just how you marinate. You're gonna let it sit for a day, and then part two will actually be you guys seeing the full meal come together. So this is the ribeye. Now listen, I don't even know where he got this from, but let me tell y'all, when we went to go get some steak the other day, the prices were crazy, were bananas. I guess they were getting ready for Valentine's Day, but it was real crazy. Now, I am going to try to stop eating beef again, but I've been on a beef kick. You hear me? Anyway, you're going to do a little bit of pepper. I believe it's going to be onion powder. Also, I believe we're going to go ahead and do garlic powder as well. And basically, we don't measure. And also, this is going to be a marinade. But you basically stop when your ancestors telling you to, okay? You're going to use seasoning salt. I don't know if garlic powder is in this one. But anyway. And I think this is a gallon freezer bag. If I'm not mistaken, that's what we're putting all of the seasonings in. You will see a few things that are different or unusual. I don't know. Maybe it is. Oh, here's the garlic powder. Maybe it is usual for people, but I don't think I've seen people put certain things in it like Robert does. And I'll tell you guys what those two things are when we get to it. And I'm not about to say one of the names of it because, baby, you won't get me. And yes, I think mustard is a little bit of a different one for me. I know mustard on chicken because my mom used to do that. But honestly, I don't recall it being on steak. Now, I feel like my mom used to make like this mustard kind of chicken, and it was so good. I'm going to have to ask her about that chicken again. This is Del's seasoning. You can also put that in string beans sometimes. It would be good. And then you just put some of that in here too, though. Also, yeah, this sauce, I say it so many different ways. Everybody says it so many different ways, but I'm not about to be the fool for y'all on this here app. So, yeah, you're going to go ahead and get that in the bag as well. And then brown sugar. I don't know if I'm used to brown sugar and steak as well, but I know brown sugar and like ketchup, a little bit of vinegar make a good barbecue sauce, but I really never thought of using it for a marinade, for steak. But you know, you do want to get a little bit of the sweetness from all the other savory seasonings that you use. And this is another one, the vegetable oil. I never really seen that in a marinade. Unless I'm tripping. But I'm almost 100% sure that I never really seen that. And then I think the next one is coming up as well. Looks like you're putting almost a cup of that in it. A half a cup. And yeah, this is the other one. Coffee. I do think I've seen it before, but I don't ever think I realize that people really put coffee and then marinate. So I think that's pretty much all. And he might do the parsley, but I don't think he actually adds it in this. Yeah. So at this point, you're going to actually get that mixture together. Basically, like you're stirring it together, but you're just basically mixing it all together so that the seasoning can be all throughout it. And you're just going to keep doing that until it is together. And then what we're going to do is place those ribeye steaks right into it. And again, I believe, like I said, this is a gallon freezer bag. So it fit all three steaks in it, plus the marinade. And then what I would also do is, because, baby, look, you know that stuff goes through plastic. Just like if you put like a tomato in here, it might leak out a little bit. I would double bag it and then put it in the refrigerator, you're going to also mix it up. And like I say, you'll leave it for the day. And then the next day you'll be ready to sear them or put them in the oven, fry them, do whatever you would like to your steak. Not really fry them, but you know what I mean. And you're going to get all the air out of it and zip it right on up. And that is basically how we do a marinade in this household. And let me just tell you, it was superb. Thank y'all for watching. Bye. Stay tuned for part 2.